Hello, everybody. My name is Sid Victa, and welcome back to RimWorld. We're going to pick up right where we left off at the end of yesterday's episode. I do appreciate it. I really hope everyone has been enjoying it. Hope you had a great holiday weekend, a new week here, new year. So what we're going to do today, just to continue on the last, I never noticed the green there, on the last episode's point was that we need to figure out a way to get all turrets firing at the same point. Now, one thing, the whole reason why I purposely pushed the entry or the exit of the kill box so much forward here was because I wanted all turrets, even the ones in the back, to immediately be able to hit. But in hindsight, that's not really that wasn't the best idea to do that, because obviously we were getting to the point where it was only like maybe these turrets over here that were firing, and that's not what we want. We want the turrets, all turrets, to fire as soon as the enemy opens up. So what I'm thinking about here is that we need to make this part solid, and it needs to be a little wide open to where they're not one by one just sitting back and, like, you know, and not entering in it. We want them all to enter almost at the same time, but we also don't want them to flood the kill box, because the kill box may get overrun. So let's go ahead and shrink the zone here. And all this stuff can get hauled. How are we doing on slate, Uncle Wayne? Ooh, we're going to need some more slate blocks. In order for us to get slate blocks, we need to haul some slate chunks. Wow, that's a lot of deer. There's a lot of robs over here, too. All right, let's get the slate hauled. That's granite. Need slate. Where can we find some slate? Okay, we gotta watch out for that warg. We may have taken all the slate off the map. Granite. Did we actually mine out all the slate? I think we have. It's four there. Yeah, I think that our map is completely slateless. No, there's still some left. Not a lot, but there is some. Now, one of the killbox designs that I've done in the past was what I like to call like a speedball type of hallway, where You would have the enemies sort of compacted here inside of the maze. It's very similar to this, except at the end it would actually open up into a triangle. So what would happen is that the enemies would sort of, like, we would create an artificial bottleneck at the beginning of the maze, and at the very end it'd be bottlenecked again, but then it opens up wide open. So that way, multiple enemies are trying to get out at the same time. That therefore, they're not going to be standing behind each other trying to take pot shots. And if we get one person with a sniper rifle that can outrange our turrets, that's going to be a pretty big problem for us. So we don't really want that to happen. Now, we did lose a turret over here, thanks to the centipede in the last episode. Not that big of a deal, but that definitely needs to get fixed. Dodger, how long is this taking you? Dodger. Okay, I take that back. She's been making marine armor this entire time. Poor Strategy Gaming, still down for the count. I know. There's nothing that we can really do about that. But, oh well, c'est la vie. C'est la vie. Now, also, I think that the cross actually got moved too low, because it's supposed to be two away from the door. Which, again, this is the reason why I don't really care about this. But people have been complaining about it, so I'm going to fix it once again. Yeah, so it needs to be here, basically. It needs to be like that. Like that, and then this sterile tile is going to be over here. And then that's going to be that, and that's going to be that, and that. Also, this also helped me realize that we need a CRL tile underneath the auto doors as well. There. So, this is like the last time I try to do something like decorative. Just trying to make, you know, like I was just arbitrarily making these crosses and be like, oh, hey, you know, this wouldn't this look neat? Isn't that cool? And then like this has been a huge point of contention for many people. Oh my God, Force is awake. Force playing poker? No. No, first thing you need to do is equip your gun. And stop getting sick, you freaking nerd. Thank you. Okay, everyone back on their work schedule, just making sure. Force is back up, so we don't need any of the these on. There we go, hunting all the alpacas. Slaver from the Kinley Gabrio is approaching there as Slaver. Well, I do want to make Little Daisy a new eye. And I believe that didn't Coach Krendor also need an eye? He's right kidney. What happened to your kidney, Coach? It's all that drinking. Consciousness. What's affecting the consciousness? Oh, no, it is his left eye as well. Okay, where's Little Daisy? Daisy's cleaning blood. Little Daisy, let's have you talk to Dan. Dan the Slaver. Or Termite the Slaver, whoever. Okay, they've got Ben, Lawson, and Min, who's a pop idol. That's literally all they have is just people. I mean, we could trade for a slave. Can I see, like, their stats? Question mark. Beautiful, super immune pyromaniac. Yeah, and she's not capable of basically anything. So, you can just hold on to Min. Talk about the Luddite Lawson. Incapable of violent. Well, that just pretty much disqualifies you. And I'll take a look at Ben, the spice miner. Capable of caring, social, intellectual, great memory, chemical fascination. All right, well, you know what, Slaver? In that case, have a couple of sculptures and get the hell out. So we're going to have 5 suits of marine armor. That's great. I do need to set up the soldier. I need to set up the soldier wardrobe function as well. Manage outfits. Let's see. Manage outfit. Select outfit. Soldier. Soldiers can have headgear. Simple helmet. War mask. T-shirt. Yeah, it looks all good. Sure. Let's leave it like that. Okay, did we get that slate cut? No. We did get a lot of the steel smelted though. Force is still rolling joints. Thank you, Force. Got a lot of smoke leaves. Got a lot of smoke leaf joints as well. Honestly, I can't believe how much the art sells for. That's really impressive. We also need to get the kibble going as well. Make the kibble. We'll say do until we have, like... Sure, 100... Let's say 200, 240. There we go. Yeah, but I need people cutting stone though, Baynard. You too, Force. Now, technically, we don't need slate. I just want to make it look nice, but we don't need slate over here. Someone rescue Force. Who the heck is Sachiko? We're getting new puppies just popping out of nowhere. Somebody rescue Force. Thank you, Wayne. I'm actually really tempted to just off Force at this point. Dude cannot stop getting sick. Is there anything that can be done about the freaking sickly wimp? We should have been like, you know what we need to do? This is probably what the comments have been saying. We need to get Penoxicillin and just make Force take it. What does Penoxicillin actually like require? I've never made medicine. Just 2 Neutroamine, that's it? There's Force's freaking assault rifle again. Bandit camp quest. AI percenter core. Yeah. We already know that we're not interested in that right now. Yeah, so Baynard just makes the Penoxicillin, and we can keep that in the hospital. See, manufactured medicine or drugs. Yeah. Now, I don't know how we can administer that directly to Force. Okay, yeah, so Force needs to be able to walk. Can I say administer? Let me see if I can do that to him. Administer Penoxicillin, yes. Okay. I wonder if there's a recommended period of time. Duration, work night 10. Plague must be taken every 5 days to remain active. Okay. Okay, so that's something that I've been completely overlooking, because I've honestly never had a chance or an opportunity to have to deal with something like this with someone as useless as Force, but we're learning, you know? Little pig has given birth. All right. We're starting to get up there in animals, like, probably too many animals at this point. Puppies and piglets need to stay in the barn. Swanky has inspired surgery. And cargo pods. Gave us chinchilla meat. Not exactly what I would say is, like, scrumptious, but... So he's being burned by superheated air. Well, that's what happens when a fire catches fire inside of, you know, a fire. Guys, dear God. Please. We've all played FTL long enough to know that that's how you deal with superheated air. Kate, what are you doing? Okay, make sure right arm was burned. Jenna is okay. What about Sohinki? Okay. Okay. So let's see if we can do a drug policy for Force. New policy. We'll say Force is a pansy policy. Okay. Now we need to edit. Force is a pansy. Recreation scheduled. Yes. Predictions? No. Scheduled penoxicillin. Every 5 days. Take to inventory zero. I don't know what take to inventory. Amount of the drug to pick up when gathering it for consumption in order to avoid having to visit the drug stockpile every time. Amount of pickup. He's taking it once every 5 days. We don't need him to pick up any inventory. Okay, so that's pretty neat. I didn't know that you could set up drug schedules and that sort of thing. That's really cool. I'm not expecting the penoxicillin to actually like cure what he's got now. I'm looking at it from a preventative measure here. Yeah, so he already took it. So hopefully the penoxicillin stops Force from getting sick. I mean, let's be honest. Who thought that Force was going to get sick this often? Kate and Jesse got into a fight. Now they're waving at each other. So who started that one, Jesse? Kate called Jesse an aunt. This drove Jesse into a rage and began to fight. And then she chatted about horseshoes with Jesse, so there's that. Bulk goods trader, it's good. It's a ship as well. Okay, this is what we've been waiting for, Little Daisy. Where's Little Daisy? Call the transport company. Here we go. Okay, we don't need this many animals, so I'm sorry. We really don't need this many animals. We truly don't. Like, I'm getting rid of most of them. Jigsaw, we can keep Jigsaw. I do not want to buy any alpacas. Nutrient paste meal, we don't really need. Okay, here we go. Components, yes. Advanced components, they only have one, that's fine. We're going to clean house here. Neutroamine, chem fuel, I'll take all that. You can have all the fur that we don't want. Plain leather, 1300. We'll save that because I know that we're going to probably get a quest for that. Camel hide. Heavy fur we're going to take. Blue fur you can have. All your steel. Give me all your steel. Give me all your plasteel. Okay, so we're 6 G's in the hole. $74. That's still good, but I'm going to sell them anyway. Masterwork, yeah, we don't need that. Take the toque. Parka normal, we'll keep that. Okay, we can sell the plasteel grand sculpture. They've got gold. We're gonna need gold for advanced components. Let's see if we can zero out this cost first before we start looking at luxury stuff. Okay. We could sell all of our cloth. We're constantly growing like cloth all the time, which is what constantly means. Here are the extra stacks. Buffalo wool. We can always grow more. And we're in the middle of December almost, so we've already got our warm clothes taken care of. So I'm going to sell the buffalo wool. Bird skin's fine. Pig skin's fine. Light leather is fine. Sell that. We're cleaning out our stores here. Yeah. I got that. Flak jacket, 51% can go. Little Daisy's making some... She's wheeling and dealing. It kind of sucks that they don't want smoke leaf, though. Okay, so we need to get all the silver that we can from them. We could sell more meat. We don't want cougar meat. We're about to cook those, so I'm not going to use that. Alpaca meat, boomalo meat, you can have that. You can have the alpaca meat, too. We'll get more meat. Buffalo meat, we'll hold on to that. Rhinoceros meat, we don't want. Lots of pork. You can have all of our pork. And cloth will get us the rest of the way there. Yeah, so there we go. So that'll get us there. There we go. There we go. Meteorite. What we got here? Okay. All right, Cassandra. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you, RimWorld. What timing? Slate issues no longer. Let's see. So, Hinky, can you, like, haul this? Thank you. It's Force's gun. Force has got a gun. He's laid out on his bum. What could his daddy do? Freaking Aerosmith. I should probably get the health monitors on. Thank you. All right. Roast beef is giving birth. Well, roast beef, that's great. Chop down some of these trees here. We need some more wood. Man, I tell you, that... The fact that the art sells for so much and that pretty much every single vendor buys it versus Smoke Leaf, which doesn't get bought by hardly anyone anymore. That's really eye-opening for me. Alright, hopefully Rob is... Where did that meteorite go? There it is. I think... Jesse, what are you doing? Oh, visiting the grave. Sorry. Okay, so we have enough steel now for the deep driller. So let's go ahead and get one of those set up. Now, the only downside to the deep driller that I don't like is that they require their own power source. Which you wouldn't think is that big of a deal, except that you have to remember if we go outside of our compound, outside of the colony, like we're gonna need to provide it with power. Yeah, we'll put it there. That was a good trade by Little Daisy. We got rid of a lot of our crap that we didn't want. We ended up making money. The colony's finances are looking pretty good now. We are low on some food, but not all of it. Danica and Banar are doing that. Eventually, though, someone will build the deep drill. Look at Wayne still cutting some slate. I appreciate that, Wayne. Baynard started a fight with Daisy. Why does everyone want to fight Daisy? What's going on here? Daisy offered a backhanded compliment about Baynard's nephew's personality. This drove Baynard and the Range to begin a fight. Why is Daisy like insulting everyone? Cargo pod. Hey, Panoxis. Very, very funny game. Thank you. Thank you, RimWorld, for the Panoxicillin. What a coinky dink. Alright, Kate's fully healed. Uncle Wayne and Mammy making some sculptures. But let's stop making the slate one though, Uncle Wayne. After this one's over, because like, I completely forgot I told him to do that, and that's where all of our slate had went. All right. Anyway, if I have to make this out of granite, then so be it. So let's make this, let's at least seal this off now. We want to seal this here. That can be like that. So when they come through, they'll be dumped off, and at this angle we can hit anything that hits or anything that enters into the kill box. And then another thing that we can do here is we can basically make it to where they don't have anywhere to hide. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so it'd be... That way that the enemies cannot, there's no flat corner that they can just, like, sort of hide behind. All right, all the deadfall traps have been rebuilt. Thank you, team. Yeah, so that... Group of mechanoids from a mechanoid hide have dropped right on top of you. They're attacking immediately. They're dropping right on top of here. That's pretty bad. Coach needs to eat. Baynard's hurt. Force, what are you doing? Force is actually up right now. Daisy and Baynard are both laid up. Everyone needs to retreat to the kill box. Like now. Like, you guys need to go, like, now. Okay, let's see how many of them are there. Three Scythers. Four Scythers. Okay, Daisy's healed. Little Daisy. Husky, get up there. Coach, I don't think you have time to eat dinner. They're not turned on. Force. Force. No, animals. Stay in the barn. Baynard's the only one who's not going to be up in the kill box. Everyone fall back into the kill box. They're trashing all of our stuff. These freaking jerks. They got charge lances too. Look at these a-holes. They're trashing all of our stuff. They're homing in on our heat signatures. Jenna. One down. Please. We can't move from here. Okay, I'm gonna give him a rabbit to chase. Come after Force. Oh, look at me. I'm Force. We got three of them. It's a good hit. Come on, turrets. You can do it. They've done it. They've done it. Good job, team. Way to sit back and do nothing and let the machines take over. Well done. Well done, team. Well done. Okay. Well, they trashed our workspace, but they didn't kill our... They didn't destroy our toolbox, at least, so that's good. These things can be rebuilt. That's not a problem. I mean, I hate losing components to that sort of thing, but I would rather lose some workstations and that sort of thing than lose like something important. This was our tailoring bench. Like, I'm completely fine with losing, like, an air conditioning unit versus, like, losing a colonist. And they didn't trash that much, so that's good. And this was a good example of why this corner here is good, because we can hit them from here, but they can't hit us. in the line of sight. That's what this whole little divot is supposed to be, is because of that. Rob, what you digging? Steel? Yeah, steel. All right. Uncle Wayne has made the slate grand sculpture. There it is. It's called Wisdom by Compassion. This piece bears an image of a campsite. The unbalanced structure of the image also almost conflicts with its pop art style. In addition to that, you squint your eyes. The dynamic composition of the image reveals the outline of a settlement. Okay. Things definitely could have been a whole lot worse. Whenever you get a mechanoid drop, that's the scariest part of it all. Baynard's still down. I don't know what happened to Baynard. Baynard also got hit in the left eye? Man. We're gonna need... So how many eyes do we actually need? I know Daisy needs one. Baynard apparently needs one as well. Coach Krendor needs one. So we need three bionic eyes. And how many advanced components are they? Four advanced components. What is this? Get the other tool bench here. Actually, no, we already have two in there. Yeah. Okay, so we need advanced components really badly. And advanced components, it's one component, 20 steel, 10 plastic with 3 gold. So, like, make, like, as much as we can here. We're gonna need 3, so we need at least 9 components, 9 advanced components to make. To make those eyes. I do want to make... I do actually want to correct, like, the vision problems that everyone has. Baynard? No. Baynard, let Rob deal with digging. You're not digging anymore. Rob gets inspired creativity. Hooray. Phenoxicillin has been made. What is Rob's crafting? Let's see. Rob is good at... Ooh, Robkin Smith. I think it's time we go for another legendary weapon here, Rob. They destroyed my machine working table, you bastards. Husky. I was wondering why the mechanoid corpses weren't moving. There we go, okay. So disassemble mechanoid forever. But we also want Rob to make... Let's have Rob make an assault rifle. Yeah, Rob, I want you doing that. After you're done eating, I want you to do this. Rob. Oh. So we're getting drained for power right now. I think it's because of the deep driller. Because these things do take a lot of power. Well, that and the ground penetrating scanner. We could turn this off for now, I guess, because we're not using it. We know that there's steel underneath where Rob is, so we'll just go with one deep driller at a time. It can take quite a while for you to burn through that. And the animals are literally eating us out of house and home right now. Okay, so let's slow our roll on smoke leaf for now. Because this stuff isn't even rolled yet. So after this one is done growing, we'll switch it out for some vegetables. Although we are about to get a pretty big influx in vegetables here. Okay, there is a grizzly bear. And a warg as well. A wolf and a lynx. Okay, so we'll have to go. We'll have to take down the predators. But I think that's a good stopping point for this episode here. So we got a lot done. Fix the hospital again. We set up the drug policy for 4 Strategy Gaming. Hopefully he will never get sick again. But, you know, let's freaking... Miracles can't happen, I suppose. We stopped that mechanoid high drop, which was great. And it also demonstrated that the kill box can work in the way that I'm intending it to. We just need a little bit more tweaking, I think. We could open up this side here a little bit more as well. I don't want them lining up so much, so I may open this by one more hex or not. I'll have to wait and see. We'll see what the comments say. But again, thank you for watching, everyone. I do appreciate all the support here on the RimWorld series. If you enjoyed the series, make sure you click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it helps out and supports my channel and the series itself. Subscribe and click the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos do go live here on YouTube. And I hope you have a great weekend. Until next time, so long, everybody.